Welcome. Today, we're taking a look at the Heritage 231 center console. The Heritage 231 is the perfect package for families looking for versatility, high capacity, and ease of trailering. This boat measures in at 22 foot 9 inches with an 8 foot 6 inch beam, 103 gallons of fuel, 14 inches of draft, and 18 degrees of dead rise at the transom. So let's start at the bow. The bow of the Heritage 231 is designed for entertainment and fishability alike. It does have wraparound seating, and it does have nice and high sides. Great feature for families. Speaking of safety, we have handrails that wrap all the way around, and of course we have cushions for the bottom. Now these cushions are removable if you're going to fish the boat, and underneath we do have storage. A box on either side as well as a box in the center. The center box does have a 5 gallon bucket cutout. To wrap everything up, a pull-up cleat, oversized anchor locker, 2 cup holders for those sitting up front, as well as 2 additional cup holders behind the backrest if you're sitting in front of the console. Speaking of the front of the console, let's take a look. The front of the console has seating for 2 people, and it does have a backrest as well as the hourglass pattern on the upholstery. The bottom cushion has a 12-gallon box, which can actually be a cooler or dry storage. If the boat is equipped with fresh water, the fresh water fill is over on the left-hand side. Let's take a look inside the console. Inside of the console, we have a couple of key features, starting with the easy access to the back of the electronics. Simply removing the mesh will give you access. Now for the families, of course, you're gonna need a porta potty, and one can be equipped inside. This is an oversized head, which actually has enough room to store all of the cushions, keeping them out of the elements. And finally, the door is lockable, making this a safe place for all of your belongings. So let's talk about the electronics on this boat. Now for the electronics on the Heritage 231, we have the SportLink electronics integration system. This is a factory installed set of electronics that comes standard with every Heritage 231. And it does have the Garmin 942 XS, which is a 9-inch touchscreen GPS, and it is paired up to the B60 through-haul transducer. Now if you notice here, the black acrylic panel. This helps with glare when you're out on the water. And it does have built-in 12-volt switches with backlit labels. And for charging ports, we have 2 USB charging ports on the right-hand side and a 12-volt receptacle on the left side. For steering, we have SeaStar's tilt helm with a Sportsman steering wheel, which has a knob. And for tunes, we have JL Audio MM50 head unit and M3 speakers all the way around. Electro-tab trim tabs with LED indicators, Yamaha binnacle, 2 cup holders, and the boat we're on today has the Garmin VHF radio. That is an option. And speaking of options, we do have the Platinum package on this boat, which includes this oversized hardtop. Let's take a look. For hardtop, you do have a color matched underside to the hull sides, of course, and additional rod holders. 4 across the back, 2 kingfish rod holders, and if you decide to add the outriggers, the plates are already welded on. Additional lights, as well as speakers, and an electronics box. Nice place for storage. To wrap everything up, we do have some grab handles here on both sides. So now, let's take a look at the leaning post. Now for leaning post on this boat, we have the deluxe leaning post, and it does feature individually adjustable bolsters. Nice feature because the captain can be standing up while a passenger is sitting, or any combination of that. It also has our ultra soft upholstery with the hourglass pattern all the way around. For safety, grab handle on both sides. Now underneath, plenty of space for a cooler, and the boat we're on today has the 65 quart Yeti with the slide out, as well as the underleaning post tackle storage. To wrap everything up, 4 rod holders across the back. Speaking of rod holders, let's check out the undergunnel rod racks. Now for rod storage underneath the gunnels, you get 3 on both sides, as well as 2 flush-mounted rod holders, a cup holder for those sitting out back, and a pull-up cleat. And the same thing over on the other side. An important thing to note here is how deep this cockpit is, making it very safe for family with kids. Now, speaking of safety, we have an undergunnel safety tow rail on both sides as well. Let's wrap it up by talking about the rear seating. Now, the rear seating in the 231 is versatile, comfortable, and spacious. A lot of room behind the leaning post, and of course, an edge-to-edge 4-person bench across the back. all of the cushions are removable if you're gonna be fishing. The key feature here is our total access hatch. Opening up this middle section reveals an extremely large entryway with best-in-class access to your bilge for any maintenance or service needed. Additional storage also inside with a lockable lid. Underneath both cushions, we have 8-gallon insulated live wells, which can double up as dry storage or coolers. 3-step boarding ladder with a handrail, and the boat we're on today also has the optional ski tow bar, and it is powder coated. For power on this boat, Yamaha 200 or 250s in mechanical, digital, or the VMAX SHO. With its 12-person capacity and spacious layout, the Heritage 231 truly is the perfect boat for those looking for versatility, ease of trailering, and high capacity. This boat, as with every other Sportsman boat, is built to ABYC standards and is NMMA certified, representing the highest in safety standards in the boating industry. If you have any questions on this or any other model, visit our website, sportsmanboatsmfg.com, or contact your local dealer. Thanks for watching.